everybody, I'm Elly Maye, here to break down what on earth happened this week. First of all, hoax crimes are on the rise. As we know, Empire actor Jussie Smollett has been arrested after filing a false police report and for disorderly conduct. Uh-oh. We all know by now that it looks like Jussie staged his own attack, but now they're saying it's because he wasn't happy with his pay on the show Empire? No. And on another note, they say women are bad negotiators, but this guy has to go through all these hoops to try to get more... No. All of it is just no. You know, maybe people are right about being afraid of toxic masculinity, because to me, Jussie is the epitome of it. His thoughts were so delusional, so toxic, that he spent thousands of dollars to have people stage the attack, blames MAGA, then runs around like some macho lunatic bragging about being the gay Tupac and bragging that he, quote, effing fought back. If that isn't toxic for society, for everyone involved, really, I don't know what is. I mean, what even is all this?
Both my doctors in LA and Chicago cleared me to perform, but said to take care, obviously. And above all, I fought the fuck back. I'm the gay Tupac.
Jussie isn't the only one who stages fake MAGA attacks. On this screen, you see several others who have done it in the last few years. So next time there is a real victim who isn't believed, they can thank these people. The victim mentality culture we live in has manifested into a hoax-fueled society where nobody knows what is real and people believe their own lies. It's scary, but the arrogance of people like Jussie, the arrogance is the pit that they fall in. It will continue to expose the fake news, the fake hate, the fake reality that the left clings to every single day. Moving on, prayers for comedian Terrance Williams, who was involved in a car accident with his Lyft driver in DC. His neck has been fractured, his back is having problems, and he will be hospitalized. He was supposed to visit the White House this week, but won't be able to attend now. Prayers for you. We are thankful for so many in the conservative movement who are visiting Terrance, so thank you for that. Keep you in our prayers. So sad, so sorry.
I'm so thankful to be alive. I'm telling y'all right now, life is short, because when I almost went over that cliff, over that bridge or whatever, I said, Lord Jesus, I'm coming home. I thought it was the end.
The Culture team, along with Laura Loomer, have officially landed in Minneapolis, Minnesota, where I hear it is snowing like crazy, so stay warm. They are there to investigate Ilan Omar, so there's a lot to look forward to with that. We will keep you posted. Speaking of Laura Loomer, she has quite the busy schedule. She was just at the Twitter headquarters again with a group of people protesting the bias against conservatives. Many signs used the hashtag #StopTheBias and pointed out Twitter's alleged anti-Semitism and outright censorship. Laura captioned a picture of herself in the snowy, miserable-looking New York weather, saying, "The people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do." Yeah, she's right about that. The ISIS bride from Alabama is now pleading to come back to the United States. I'm sorry. I keep getting told by the left that the United States is this horrible place. Now she wants to come back. She left in 2014 to join ISIS, but now wants to come back with her child. President Trump and Secretary of State Mike Pompeo said no.
No.
Attorney Lynn Wood spoke to Culture after filing a $250 million lawsuit against the Washington Post for Covington Catholic's Nick Sandman. He said, "In a span of 3 days in January of this year, commencing on January 19th, the Washington Post engaged in a modern-day form of McCarthyism to claim leadership of a mainstream and social media mob of bullies which attacked, vilified, and threatened Nick Sandman, an innocent minor." Those are some strong words, and I think the Washington Post should be afraid. Quite frankly. Street artist The Faction made a little adjustment to John Oliver's billboard in LA, with art based on the NPC in Orange Man Bad memes. Bill Maher's billboard got a similar treatment just a few weeks ago. I'm not saying that's one of the best things I've ever seen, but that's one of the best things I've ever seen. Anyway, I am going to leave you with this meme, and I hope you enjoy it. I will see you next week. I'm Elly Maye. Follow Culture. Yeah, I'm so cold like, yeah. Yeah, I'm so dull like, yeah. Woo. We gon' blow like, yeah.
Slipping up. Look what I'm whipping up. This is America. Don't catch you slipping up. Don't catch you slipping up. Look what I'm whipping up. Look how I'm geeking up.